Text can be represented in MATLAB using character vectors or string scalars. If the text is bounded within single quotes, it is a character vector, and if it is inside double quotes, it is a string. A character vector is a vector which consists of any number of characters. Since it is a vector, you can find its size and length, or even its transpose. On the other hand, string scalars store group of characters. They are scalars, so if you ask for their size or length, the answer is always similar to a scalar. Even if the string contains no character, it still isn't empty. You can check it with isEmpty function. The strlength function returns the number of characters inside the string, and to check if a string is empty, you should use this command. To convert these text types, you can easily use char and string command. Also remember that a string scalar is actually a character vector stored inside a cell, so we can extract individual characters of a string. To concatenate strings, use plus operator, and to concatenate character vectors, put them inside a vector. These ways only work for one of these text types, but strcat function operates on both of them. To compare text variables, you cannot use equality operator. Since a character vector is actually a matrix, if you use equality operator, it compares its characters one by one, and if their lengths do not match, you'll see an error. Use these two functions instead. If the case of the characters is important, strcmp, and if not, strcmpi. Converting between text and number types. To convert numbers into strings, use int2str. It works for vectors and matrices too. To convert a string to a number, obviously the string must consist of numbers. Use either str2double or str2num. If the string contains any non-numerical character, the result would be nan, not a number. str2num can also convert a string to a numerical vector, but str2double cannot. Now let's see if we can receive a vector from the user. You probably know that to receive a number or a string from the user, we use input function. By default, it only accepts a number. If I give it a vector, it shows me an error message. Now if I add single quote as single quote, it can receive a string, and I enter my vector. I can easily convert this variable to a numerical vector using str2num. And that's it. Thank you for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and like this video. Bye bye.